Supreme excellence consists of breaking the enemy's resistance without fighting. And this is something biological warfare is good at. This is Globe Z, and our today's content is based on biological warfare, also known as germ warfare. Primarily, it is the use of biological toxins or infectious agents such as bacteria, viruses, insects, and fungi, with the intent to kill or incapacitate humans, animals, or plants as an act of war. Biological weapons, often termed as bioweapons, are living organisms or replicating entities such as viruses, which are not universally considered as alive. Biological weapons may be employed in various ways to gain a strategic or tactical advantage over the enemy, either by threats or by actual deployments. Like some chemical weapons, biological weapons may also be useful as an area denial weapons. These agents may be lethal or non-lethal and may be targeted against a single individual, a group of people, or even an entire population. They may be developed, acquired, stockpiled, or deployed by nation states or by non-national groups. In the latter case, it may also be considered as bioterrorism. Let's have a brief overview of the legal framework in allusion to biological warfare. Offensive biological warfare, including mass production, stockpiling, and use of biological weapons, was outlawed by the 1972 Biological Weapons Convention, often known as BWC Treaty. The rationale behind this treaty, which has been ratified by 170 countries as of April 2013, is to prevent a biological attack which could conceivably result in large number of civilian casualties and cause severe disruption to economic and societal infrastructure. Here it is interesting to note that the biological warfare containment can only be witnessed in the recent times, though bioweapons is something which can be traced back to ancient history. Rudimentary forms of biological warfare have been practiced since antiquity. The earliest documented incident of the intention to use biological weapons is recorded in Hittite texts of 1500 to 1200 BC, in which victims of tularemia were driven into enemy lands, causing an epidemic. Similarly, Scythian archers dipped their arrows and Roman soldiers their swords into excrements and cadavers, infecting victims with tetanus. In addition to this, precedents of modern history also substantiate the wars fought on biological grounds. British Army have been alleged to use smallpox against Native Americans during the siege of Fort Pitt in 1763, an outbreak that left as many as 100 Native Americans dead. Similarly, during the days of both the World War I and II, use of biological weapons remained on top of the strategic plans. During the final months of World War II, Japan planned to use plague as a biological weapon against US civilians in San Diego, California, during Operation Cherry Blossoms at night. The plan was set to launch on 22nd September 1945. But it was not executed because Japan's surrender on 15th August 1945. Similarly, in 1974, Iraq stated that the government had adopted a policy to acquire biological weapons. A research and development biological weapons program was established under the Al-Hazen Ibn Al-Haytham Institute at a site located in Al-Salman. The work was poorly directed, coupled with lack of appropriate facilities and equipment. It was said the institute achieved little and it closed in 1978. Later, Saddam Hussein initiated an extensive biological weapons program in Iraq in the early 1980s in violation of the Biological Weapons Convention of 1972. Details of the biological weapons program, along with a chemical weapons program, surfaced only in the wake of the Gulf War in the early 90s. Though the Iraqis claimed to have destroyed their biological arsenal after the 1991 war, yet they did not provide confirmatory evidence. During the UN inspection in 1998, it emerged that Hussein had had prisoners tied to sticks and bombarded with anthrax and chemical weapons for experimental purposes. These experiments began in the 1980s during the Iran-Iraq war after initial experiments on sheep and camels. Dozens of prisoners are believed to be killed during the program. Thus, international concerns led to renewed inspections in 2002 under UN Security Council resolution, and Iraq's biological weapons were again targets for the US military during the 2003 invasion of Iraq. In fact, President Bush cited the existence of potentially fatal biological weapons as a major justification for military action. Biological warfare as a means of terrorism. Biological weapons are difficult to detect, economical, and easy to use, making them appealing to terrorists. The cost of a biological weapon is estimated to be about 0.05% the cost of a conventional weapon in order to produce similar numbers of mass casualties per kilometer square. Moreover, their production is very easy as common technology can be used to produce biological weapons like that used in productions of vaccines, foods, sprays, devices, beverages, and antibiotics. A major factor about biological warfare that attracts terrorists is that they can easily escape before the government agencies have even started their investigation. This is because the potential organism has incubation period of 3 to 7 days, after which the results begin to appear, thereby giving terrorists a lead. In 2002, when CNN went through Al-Qaeda's experiments with crude poisons, they found out that Al-Qaeda had begun planning ricin and cyanide attacks with the help of loose association of terrorist cells. The associates had infiltrated many countries like Turkey, Italy, Spain, France, and others. In 2015, to combat the threat of bioterrorism, a national blueprint for biodefense was issued by Blue Ribbon Study Panel on Biodefense. Besides this, bioweapons are also a part of the intellectual debate in the contemporary world. As all of us are hammered hard with the outbreak of deadly COVID-19, more commonly known as coronavirus, since its outbreak in Wuhan City, China, the simmering blame game has been in the limelight. President Trump called COVID-19 the Chinese virus, and in response to statement issued by US President, Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson made an unproven claim on Twitter saying it might be the US military who brought the epidemic to Wuhan, the epicenter of the pandemic. Russia is also a part of the big game. Pro-Russian news agencies such as Russian Channel 1 promote conspiracy theories that British scientists made COVID-19 and UK had a vaccine too, while Iran also claimed it was a bioweapon. Therefore, the blame game clearly shows the debate the outbreak of the pandemic was on purpose and used as a tactical weapon in biological warfare. However, the truth about the origin of the deadly virus is yet to be disclosed, and all conspiracy theories are merely in the category of speculations. To conclude, the implications of biological warfare are not limited to physical domains. Rather, it also surrounds social, economic, political, and spheres of human activities. And though the use of biological weapons to gain tactical advantage over adversaries has not been in a global spotlight, yet it is a potential threat to the existence of life on the planet. Hope you like our today's content. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe. And thank you for watching.